Honorable Judge Rodney Burris presiding.
Thank you. Please be seated.
Court will call the case of Commonwealth of Kentucky versus Tiffanie Lucas. This is case number 23-CR-404. The record will reflect the Commonwealth is represented by the Honorable Bailey Taylor. The defendant appears today. He's represented by the Honorable Richard Lawzak and the Honorable Jonathan Villavicencio. I got that right. Close enough. Matter is put before the court on the defendant's motion to review the status of her plea. Would the defense attorneys like to address the issue?
Yes, Your Honor. At this time, Ms. Lucas is prepared to enter a change of plea. We would enter an open plea to both charges as alleged in the indictment. We have a motion enter a plea, our guilty plea form prepared today, so we can go forward with that. And we would just note for the record that this time there's no notice of aggravating circumstances filed in this case, which is a material condition of our interest in entering this plea.
All right, the defendant at this time is charged with two counts of murder, both the capital offenses. You've indicated it's her desire to enter an open plea. Is she intending to enter a plea of guilty to both of those charges?
Yes, sir.
And as an open plea, Mr. Taylor, I assume the Commonwealth is not making a recommendation then?
That is correct.
All right, I need counsel to approach the bench. Lucas, I need you to please raise your right hand, ma'am. Do you swear or affirm the testimony you are about to give will be the truth, the whole truth, and nothing but the truth?
Yes, sir.
Thank you. Put your hand down. Would you gentlemen move that microphone right in front of her, ma'am? I think you're going to need to speak up just a little bit. Can I have your full name?
Tiffanie and Catherine Lucas.
Your address?
213 Bentley Drive, Shepherdsville, Kentucky.
Your date of birth?
10/2/91.
And may I have the last four digits of your social security number?
0811.
How much education do you have?
High school.
Then you can read and write?
Yes, sir.
Do you suffer now or have you ever suffered from any mental illness or defect which would affect your ability to think and reason?
No, sir.
At this time, are you ill or are you in any way impaired in your judgment?
No, sir.
Are you under the influence of alcohol or any other type of drug?
No, sir.
You understand what's happening in court at this time?
Yes, sir.
Ma'am, the indictment in this case charges in count one, on or about the 8th day of November of 2023 in Bullitt County, Kentucky. The above-named defendant, Tiffanie Lucas, committed the offense of capital murder when she intentionally caused the death of J.H. by shooting him with a gun. Count two charges that on or about the 8th day of November of 2023, In Bullitt County, the above defendant Tiffanie A. Lucas committed the offense of capital murder when she intentionally caused the death of M.B. by shooting him with a gun. Now, ma'am, do you admit that you are the person named in that indictment?
Yes, sir.
Do you understand the facts that you are charged with in that indictment?
Yes, sir.
Has your attorney explained to you the nature of the charges against you, their penalty, and any possible defense that you might have?
Yes, sir.
Ma'am, you have the following rights. You have a right to a trial by jury, where you will be represented by your attorney, and the Commonwealth will have to prove your guilt beyond a reasonable doubt. You have a right not to testify against yourself or incriminate yourself in any way. You have a right to confront and cross-examine any witness which the Commonwealth would produce to testify against you. You also have a right to appeal to a higher court any conviction which you might receive at the jury trial in this court. Now, do you understand that you have those rights, but you do give them up when you enter a guilty plea?
Yes, sir.
Have you discussed your guilty plea with your attorney?
Yes, sir.
Have you had all the time that you need to talk privately with your attorney?
Yes, sir.
Is there anything that you've asked your attorneys to do in your defense that they have failed to do?
No, sir.
Are you satisfied with their services?
Yes, sir.
Ma'am, I've been presented here with a written motion to enter a guilty plea. Did you read this motion?
Yes, sir.
And did you sign it voluntarily?
Yes, sir.
And is it your wish at this time to enter a guilty plea which follows the recommendation that is contained in the written offer? Counsel, would you approach the bench? Ms. Lucas, you have read this document?
Yes, sir.
And you have initialed the paragraphs that do not apply to your case, is that correct?
Yes, sir.
Is it your wish at this time to enter a guilty plea then to the charges in this case without a recommendation from the Commonwealth?
Yes, sir.
You understand, ma'am, that on each count, the potential penalty is 20 to 50 years in prison or a life sentence, and that the counts could be concurrent, meaning at the same time, or they could be consecutive, meaning one right after the other?
Yes, sir.
And have you discussed all of the issues relating to probation, parole, and other matters in this guilty plea with your attorney?
Yes, sir.
And then it is your desire at this time to enter a plea of guilty to the two counts?
Yes, sir.
Ms. Lucas, on count one, do you admit and plead guilty to the offense of murder?
Yes, sir.
On count two, do you admit and plead guilty to the offense of murder?
Yes, sir.
And you enter each of these pleas of your own free will because you are guilty and for no other reason?
Yes, sir.
Knowing that you have the rights I've described to you, do you still wish to give up those rights and enter this guilty plea?
Yes, sir.
Now, ma'am, you understand that by waiving your right to an attorney, to a jury trial, the court will be required to set your punishment within the limits allowed by law?
Yes, sir.
And is your request that this happen this way?
Yes, sir.
Counsel, I'm going to ask the defense attorney, do you acknowledge that you represent Ms. Lucas in this matter?
Yes, sir.
Do you acknowledge her identity?
I do.
And have you explained to her the nature of the charges against her, their penalties, and any possible defenses she might have?
We have.
Have you explained to her her constitutional rights?
We have.
In your opinion, does she understand those rights and the nature of these proceedings?
She does.
Is her plea of guilty consistent with your advice?
It is.
And in your opinion, having conferred with the defendant, is her decision to enter a guilty plea made knowingly, voluntarily, and intelligently?
Yes, sir.
The court will then make a finding the defendant's plea is made knowingly, voluntarily, and intelligently. Mr. Taylor, there is no recommendation from the Commonwealth at this time on a guilty plea. The Commonwealth will be allowed to ask for whatever you would like to ask for at the time of sentencing, as will the defense. defense have a position on her parole eligibility at this time?
No, Your Honor, we understand she's not eligible for parole.
Well, she might be eligible for parole.
Probation.
She would not be eligible for. You understand we'll need someone from probation and parole here then, Mr. Taylor, to testify as to that and I have a sentencing. How long do you anticipate needing for the defense for sentencing?
I would imagine, Your Honor, maybe an hour and a half conservatively for our portion.
Mr. Taylor, how long do you anticipate needing for the prosecution?
I would think no more than an hour, Your Honor.
How is November 22nd then at 9 o'clock a.m. for sentencing?
We're available, Your Honor.
Court will order the Division of Probation and Parole prepare a pre-sentence investigation report, pass the matter to that date for final sentencing. Is there anything else for today?
No, Your Honor.
No, Your Honor.
Court is adjourned.